Hi there! In this tutorial, I'll show you how you can make your typographic workflows with TextMeshPro so much easier. You will learn about the asset settings, and we will figure out text styles. It's going to be awesome! First, one thing that will have no effect on anything you already created, but everything going forward. The TextMeshPro settings. You will find it under Edit, Project Settings, TextMeshPro. You might have to click on Import Essentials first if you haven't set up TMP yet. Once done, you'll see a new menu item pop up, Settings. Here you can set the default values and checkmarks to many of the most basic TMP text components. Most importantly, the default font asset, so new text boxes actually start with your basic chosen font instead of the standard Liberation font. Once this is set up, it will save you so much time. At least it did for me. The next important settings are the text container default settings. I always give the X values a few more pixels, set the raycast target to disabled, since most of my texts don't need to be clickable, and increase the default font size by a bit. Take note of this info at the top too. We are going to need this later. Onwards to styles. You are already well familiar with these settings down here. Your actual font asset to handle which font is being used, font styles, alignment. Have you ever clicked on this dropdown before? Let's see what we have here. This is a list of predefined style sheets, which somehow all relate to printed media. Headlines, quotes, links, and so on. They come in handy as a reference on how to write your own, but that's about the extent of their usefulness, to be honest. These dropdown styles always affect the complete content of the text container, not just individual parts, like, for example, setting a single word to bold. More on that later. We can't really use any of these, so let's write our own. All of these text styles can be found in TextMeshPro's Style Sheet folder, in the aptly named Default Style Sheet. Here, all of them are listed. As you can see, they all have a name, an automatically generated hash code, and an input field for opening and closing tags. If you have ever worked with CSS before, you will probably understand what's going on here at first glance, but for everybody else. If you want to change the look of the contents in a text container, you need to use so-called tags. A tag usually consists of an opening tag and a closing tag. This, for example, is a tag for bold this text. You can distinguish between opening and closing tags easily by looking for this slash. It marks the end of the area you want to be affected by the style. Thus, in the default example, we can see a tag for the size of the affected text, a tag for making it bold, and a tag to set the text's colors. Lastly, there are even the randomly added asterisks too. Let's change it to something we can actually use. Decrease the size value to something like 1.3 or up to 1.5 em for this. By the way, em refers to the typographic size of roughly one uppercase letter M in your chosen font. Thus, 1 em means the size of the font will stay the same as set, while a size of 2 em doubles it. Let's keep B for this tutorial, but change the color hex value to something else. Lastly, delete the asterisks. If nothing is changing, you need to click on your headline text container and choose text style H1. This already looks kind of okay to me. But you can go further, of course, and let's do so. Let's add one of the most interesting tags you can add, the font tag. With this, you can tell your headline to use a specific font asset. Two caveats for this. It of course needs to be a TextMeshPro font asset, and you remember this folder, you will need to place the font asset here or TextMeshPro won't be able to find it. I want my headline to have this font, so I enter the exact spelling of the font asset here and… Yep, it works. TextMeshPro's documentation lists a whole bunch of these tags you can use. I very much recommend having a look at them. For this project, I don't need any of the remaining styles, so I remove them by clicking here. Ah, but wait, I forgot my body text. So I add a new style, name it body, and add a few tags I prepared beforehand. A bit of character spacing, a bit of line spacing, which I recommend on any kind of text, and again a custom font. I will tell my body text container to use it, check if I like the results and apply the changes to my prefab so it will remember to use the styles for the text boxes. Now I can finally drop in my custom-made text box wherever I like, and if I choose to change fonts or settings or visuals at some point, I don't need to touch them at all. I just change the font in the style sheet. And of course, I could create a couple more actually game-relevant styles to change up the optics and use cases of my basic text element too. Lastly, I'll cover inline styles. These get applied only to certain parts of your text, like a word set to bold. Let's create a new style, call it bold, and give it the corresponding tags. Back in your text container, you can now click directly before the word you want to change the appearance of and write style equals bold directly in front of it. And as you can see, everything behind it will now be changed to bold, so we need to use a closing tag too. This gets placed directly behind the word. There is no difference between inline styles and paragraph styles, so you could of course just use every other style you already set up too. And lastly, you can use the style tag inside of style sheets too, so you can even further tweak how the results should look like. That's all for text styles in TextMeshPro. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial and learned a thing or two in the process. Please let me know if you did. And I'm curious, did you use text styles before? Leave me a comment, I'd love to know.